If you are new to the channel, then subscribe the channel and press the bell icon for further notification. Okay, student, welcome you all to this new lecture in Power System series. So today again, we will be solving 5 questions starting from 161 to up to 165. Okay, then let's try to solve these questions.
Okay, in question number 161, there are 2 generators in a power system. No load frequencies of the generators are this much and this much, respectively, and both are having same group characteristics, 1 hertz per megawatt. That is the slope of that straight line. The load of the system is 2.5 megawatt. Assume the generators are operating under their respective group characteristics. The frequency of the power system in hertz in steady state is equal to. So this is of this fashion. This is your load and this side is your frequency. So this is at zero load. So zero load, one frequency is, one generator is having frequency 51.5. And the slope is equal, so they will be parallel lines. So this point is, for one case it is 0, 51.5. And for the second one it is 0, 51. And the slope is same, so they are operating at a constant frequency, same frequency. So at this, the frequency should be same because they are operating parallel. So this is the same frequency. One is operating at this point, one is operating at this point. So sum of these two, if this is x, then this should be 2.5 minus x, because total load should be equal to this plus this should be equal to 2.5 megawatt. That is given. So you can write the equations of this slope, these lines, because this line slope, you know, it is minus 1 per megawatt, minus 1 by 1. So 1 hertz per megawatt, this is given. So minus 1 this slope is. So you can write the equations of this equation, so which is equal to F1 minus 51.5 is equal to MX2, or Y equal to MX plus C also you could have written. Anything you want to do, you can do P1 minus 0. So F1 is equal to 51.5 minus P1, and similarly for F2 it will be, now I am writing Y equal to MX plus C, so M, that is P2 plus C is 51, so same here, 51 minus P2. But because they are operating at same frequency, so the output of these two frequencies should be equal when P1 is equal to X, or no, this is P1, the bigger one we have considered P1, and this is P2, the smaller one, this second one. So P1 equal to P2, so this should be equal. So 51.5 minus X, which one I have considered, you can consider any one. This is 2.5 minus X, 51.5 minus 2.5 minus X, this one is equal to 51 minus X. So if you solve it, you will get it. So X is equal to 1, so this is the thing you are getting. That means your P2 is equal to 1, this is 1, and this is your 1.5. So once you know anything, this height is required. What is the frequency? Because both the frequencies are equal, these and these are equal, F1 equal to F2. So which is equal to, you can put either there or there, wherever you are feel comfortable. So if you put P2 here, if you take this one, then I will put P2. So this is the 50 hertz that it is maintained. So that's why this is the answer. A synchronous generator is connected to an infinite bus with an excitation voltage this much. A generator has a synchronous reactance of this and is delivering real power of 0.60 per unit to the bus. Assuming infinite bus voltage to be this, neglect the stator resistance and the reactive power supplied by the generator to the bus. Okay, under this condition. So this is the case, there is a generator and then you are supplying this one to this. This is one at an angle of 0. This is 1.3, you don't know the angle. And this reactance they have given, that is 1.1. Now it is delivering 0.6 per unit real power. So power is equal to 1.3 into 1 divided by 1.1 sine delta, which is equal to 0.6 they have given. So from here you can calculate your delta is equal to 30.51 degree. Now you know this angle also. So they are asking what is the reactive power that is supplied by the generator to the bus. So how much reactive power is supplied by this to the bus? Now if you calculate reactive power supplied by this, then because there is a reactor in between them, no real power loss will be there, but reactive power loss will be there. So if you calculate the reactive power supplied by the generator, then this will be whatever reactive power, it some portion will come here and some will be lost in the line. So you will get that lost plus this, but they are asking the reactive power generated by the generator to the bus, supplied by the generator to the bus, how much reactive power is coming here, that is asking. Because this generator will be supplying suppose 10, so 2 will be lost, 8 will be coming here. So if you calculate from this side, you will get 10 as the answer, but 10 they are not asking, they are asking at how much is supplied by this generator in this bus. So that's why you calculate here reactive power, because in the road there will be loss. So how much reactive power is here, what is there, Vi star, Sp plus jq is equal to vi star, we know this one. So you will take v this one. That's why you will take v this one, not this v. If you take this v, then you will get 10, this q. P will be whatever it supplied, that will directly come here because no resistance, no real power drop. But because reactance is there, so there will be reactive power drop. So this will be 1.3 at an angle of 30.51 minus 1 angle 0 divided by 1.1 J, this much star. Now I think you can take star, this will be minus, this will be minus, and this J will be minus. And then you change that sign, do some little bit polar to rectangular, rectangular. This 1 angle 0 is nothing but same. Or you will get something of this version. 0.6 plus J.11 or 0.109 actually, so you'll get near about 0.11. So Q will be equal to 0.11. So this is your answer. A synchronous generator is shown in the figure is supplying active power to an infinite bus. So this is supplying to this power via two short lines, transmission line, initially in steady state. The mechanical input power of the generator and the voltage magnitude of E are constant. This is constant E and the mechanical input. If one line is stripped at T1 time, by opening these two circuit breakers at two ends, this line has been opened. Although there is no fault, just this is opened. Then it is seen that the generator undergoes a stable transient. Delta will change because the network has changed. Which one of the following waveforms of the rotor angle D shows the transients correctly? So one thing you know, what should be delta value? Delta is initially it should be positive or negative, because you are supplying power to from this to this side. So your delta should be positive. If delta is positive, then only you can, it should be more, the angle should be more from this to this side, then only it can supply. So if it is zero, it should be positive. So obviously these and these is not the answer, C and D. So it should be A and B. Now you see whether your initial delta is increasing or initial delta is decreasing. If it is increasing, this one. So it, here the figure will be something like this of the. So this is your original network when it was x by 2. Now if you change it to x, then it will, P max will reduce, because earlier P max, whatever you are dividing by x by 2, small number. Now you will divide it by, if you open this line, only x will be there. So P max will be now increased, because you will, you can see you are dividing here 5, you are dividing here 10, because you are dividing by more, so P max will reduce. So the new characteristic will something like of this fashion. So suppose the load is of this fashion. So it was operating at this point. So when you suddenly it will open, it will come here. Operating point initially first here, then it will try to increase because it has to go here, so it will increase sometime in this equal area criteria will again come, again it will swing, finally it will come. So what is the initial swing? So this is your delta zero. So whenever there is a, you change the, you open this bracket, it directly came here, and then from here it will increase. So first there is an increase in delta, increase, then after some time it will decrease. So delta will first increase. So the initial swing of delta should be increased. So this one here, delta is decreasing after T1. So it is not correct. So this one is the correct answer. That is option A. Now if you come to 164, a 50 Hz generator with H constant is given this much. The machine initially operating a steady state sync producing 1 per unit real power. The initial value of rotor angle delta is equal to 5 when the bolted 3-phase ground to fault occur at the terminal voltage. It was operating at 5 volt. At that instant the fault occurs. Assuming that the input power to remain constant at 1, the value of delta in degrees 0.2 seconds after the fault. Okay, so what is your that swing equation? From that we will find the acceleration of the delta. So in per unit, this is of this fashion. For per unit you don't write g, so this is per unit acceleration. So what will be accelerating power? This is 1 minus, because output is 0, it is faulted. So it will be, it is 2180. I am writing in degree because they are asking in degree. So del square delta by del t square is equal to 1. So from here if you calculate, your acceleration of delta is equal to 4500 electrical degree per second square. Okay, so you need to find the final speed. So you can remember Newton's theorem, B is equal to ut plus half at t square, where V is the velocity of initial. So omega into t, that is your theta actually. So if I change, if I say d theta by dt, that is actually, it is velocity. So this is actually this one, this into this actually theta. What is its initial theta? 0. And it is its final theta. So this is your final theta, this is your initial theta, and this is acceleration of theta, this is time. Sorry, this is s equal to, s is equal to ut. So final theta will be this much, how much distance you travel, that is speed into time, which is the distance. Here it is in terms of angular displacement, so distance is here means theta, that is radian, how much you move. So this is 5 plus half into This is 4500 into time is 0.00, sorry, 0.02 whole square. So if you do this one, you will get it to 5.90. So that is your answer. Okay, now if you come to 165, the figure shows the single end diagram of a single machine infinite system. Inertia is given this much, the frequency is 50, mechanical input is given. It is at stable equilibrium, rotor angle delta 0 is equal to given. Three phase short circuit fault at a certain location on one of the circuits of the doubles. Okay, there is a fault. One of the circuit of the double line transmission line. During the fault, the power is this one, P max. The values of delta and delta, the instant of tearing angle is this much given. So what is given? Your value of delta and d delta by dt at the time of clearing it is given. Okay, theta c. Then the P max in power unit. That is P max is during fault. So you know this type of. So this is if this is it. So during fault it get reduced, and after fault it again comes down. So something of this fashion it will be. This is your pre-fault. This is your during fault, and this is after your fault remove. So I think you know all these things. So it was operating at this point. So during fault it will come to this curve. It will go at some point. Suppose here it is clear. So this is delta 0. This is delta C, which is given 30 degree. This is also given 45 degree. And when it goes there, it will go up to this one. So this area should be equal to this area. That is the idea. And this is delta theta max. Now for calculating this, this you can think it of this way. Suppose this is given, so I can calculate this one. What will be my delta max? This 180. Suppose this is delta, then 180 minus delta. So let me calculate this one, because your output is given at mechanical input is given. So this was at one per unit. But you don't know the Pmax equation. So from that you should have calculated theta, but you don't know, because this X reactance is nothing is given to you. So you cannot use this one. But one thing is given: during this point your d theta by dt, that is your omega change in angle, that is omega is, you can see, of relative speed also, that change in angle is given this much radian per second. So you can use that one, that is known as omega, or omega 2 you can say. This position it is omega 1. What is omega 1? Omega 1 is 0, because it is stable position. It is at omega 2 where it reached this position, delta C. This is at this position, angle is 45, but the rate of change of angle is this much given. They have given 3.762 radian per second. So you will use the second one. First one we cannot use angle, because we don't know the X. Okay, so to introduce that one, how to calculate this rate of change of angle, swing equation for second, this one, for during fault I am writing. So it is 1, so this one we don't know, P max sine delta. That's what we need to calculate. 1 is my initial value. This is the accelerating portion I am writing. So this is 5 by, I am writing in radian, because I need everything is in radian per second. So pi I have written, pi, that is 3.14 I will write. And here I will write it d omega r by dt. Omega r, it can say it is a relative speed of this fashion. So P max sine delta. So here I think you have done these things to give a 2 omega r and d omega r dt, because I have written here 2, I have written here, so it will cancel out, because I have written 1 extra omega r. So I will give omega r that side. What is omega r? D delta by dt. So this one is written instead of this. Omega r and these are same. So these two are equal. So if you can cancel dt both sides, so it will be 5 by, or I am writing it still 2 pi 50, whatever. We will do it in later. So this one you can write 2 omega r dr, d omega r. And this is 1 minus pm sine delta d theta. dt I have cancelled from both sides. Or I have taken integration with respect to t, whatever. So 5 by again, that is 100 pi. So this one you can write it d omega r square, because d omega r square is 2 omega r d omega r square. If you differentiate it this one, so it is d omega r, 2 omega r, then d omega. And this one is 1 minus pm sine delta as it is. Now you take integration both sides, and this will be integration from these to this, omega 1 to omega r 1 to omega r 2 you can write. Don't get confused, these are not synchronous speed, these are relative speed, that change in theta delta with respect to time because of disturbance. So here it will go from this place to this place. Your delta is moving from delta 1 to delta 2, and delta 1 moves from this to this, so then this one moves from this to this. So if you do this one, it is 5 by 100 pi. Now it will come till omega, differentiation of x is this x only, so this r square. So you'll put, you can put upper limit, so 2 square minus omega r 1 square is equal to, this is 30 degree, this is 45 degree. So you can write it theta plus Pm cos of theta pi by 6 to pi by 4. You put all these values here. This is equal to 3.762 and this is 0. This you already know. This side you everything you know, only Pmax you don't know. You put all these values, first pi by 4 plus Pm cos pi by 4, then pi by 6 minus Pm cos pi by 6. All these things you put. Finally, if you calculate, I am not doing it, you can finally do it. The answer will be this much.
If you like the video, then press the like button and please give your valuable comments in the comment section.